Hello, welcome back to the dungeon. So as you can see, well, I had to restart because I died. I killed the boss that was in this room, and then suddenly a guy from the left appeared and a guy from the right appeared. So I was very, very wounded. I think I had 20 HP left, and someone from the left and from the right was coming closer to kill me. That was not fun. So I guess the boss is behind that door. And I guess we just throw stuff at them until we get stronger. Oh, we hit something. What about this? Can this do damage if thrown? I'm not sure. Oh, that was actually a great round. Wait, what is this? Should I eat it? Oh, it's lingonberry. Yeah, I should eat it. Yeah, I should probably drink this as well. And that's another throwing weapon. To be honest, I don't think it really changes anything if you throw those weapons at the enemy, but at least you feel better. I mean, you feel like in a Jackie Chan movie, you use all objects around you. Now, a very important thing is to search everywhere. I wish you could rotate items. A very important thing is to search everywhere because you might even get some items that are useful. Well, that's not useful. Guess we can do this. Yeah, let's put the riches near the food. That'll be splendid. And yeah, there's usually just food in those barrels. So I'm searching for traps in order to defeat the boss with, because the first boss is the hardest one. Oh, this guy might have came from this place. No ha. Oh, this will hurt. Okay, let's rest a little bit. I mean, your objective when you're playing the game is to first kill most of the enemies, then the boss, and then the rest of the enemies. Otherwise you'll be in trouble, because they'll surround you. You could also take the Warcry, which is super useful, but I don't want to waste my point. That's a very bad room. There is three people with huge axes in there. My instincts tell me I have to go and say hello to the fresh air outside. Really, how is this possible? I think there is a problem with the dungeon generation. This is not a band we can defeat in the beginning. Well, I guess we can start working. We're like Deadeye, or who was that character that was throwing stuff at Spider-Man in the... No, at Daredevil, when they used to fight. The TV series. Yeah, those guys are not fun at all. And also noticed another thing, sometimes the enemies will find you when you are resting. See what I mean? I was only resting and they found me, so I guess the noise propagation is real. Wait, let's throw this thing. I love that sound effect. That was worth it. Of course, now you want to run away. That sound effect is so funny when you smash the jar in his head or the pottery in his head. Okay, keep in mind we don't have any healing items per se, so we just have to keep our stats very, very lower. Just keep them under control. Oh, it actually reduces in size when you eat from it. That's so cool. Okay, so we're back to full strength. And there's another enemy. Yeah, said that this is how you're supposed to play. Well, more or less. Oh, my stupid chair. I think I have to buy another chair. I just bought a new chair and it's kind of bad already, I don't know. It seems like the gaming chair market is going down the drain very fast. Since you cannot get quality gaming chairs anymore, you just get something and you hope it's good, okay? Now this is what I want to avoid. I mean, we might still die to the boss, because we have no armor, we're basically a barbarian. Let's get away a bit, because he might show up over there. Looks like it's just too dangerous to play without this ability. Because in the beginning I don't have anything to defend against. What was that? Did he call me closer to him? So let's see his stats thanks to our little curses effects. Weakness. Fumble chance plus 10%. Okay, so basically everything is worse for him. And also with the initiative loss, the fumble chance is free, so it's 13% fumble chance. So he'll not be able to hit us very well. See, that was a fumbled attack. Well, even a small hit from him is very bad. Yeah, well, I guess while we heal up, we can destroy this stuff and eat some apples and have some fun. That's crazy, that was not all of the enemies? Okay, this guy is very weak, so let's throw the axe at him. This is useless. I might hit him once or twice. I'm just better off using my two abilities in the beginning. And I guess the nice part is that this works with any melee character. That's 49. I guess that's for a quest as well. I also like to heal while I'm walking in the dungeon, so as you can see, if I'm not strong enough, I'll just do something else while I'm strong enough. This is the kitchen, perfect. So we'll have water and some other good stuff over here. Let's see if we hit. I'm curious about the damage of a two. Yeah, it's the same almost. Mercy, now you ask for mercy. Yeah, our character is doing very well actually. Also, like I said, you want the piglet little debuff because you'll have increased health restoration. Also, don't eat when you have that ability, I mean that trait activated. Oh, you can select in which one you will... Okay, I don't know what's up with this dungeon, but there are so many people, we're almost leveled up. I guess I should use that when they're closer to me, okay, I'll do it next time. And this is useless. I'm much better off just using the ability when they are close to me. What? Stun? Double stun. Well, I guess it's time to relax a little bit and eat more. 70 turns of satiety. Also, this is where the immunity is so important because this will actually help us reduce the toxicity. So let's see how much it helps us reduce the toxicity over cities. Yeah, it's actually a pretty good rate. I like it. We're also very confused and intoxicated and just generally feeling bad. Okay, let's go near the barrel. This is pretty bad. I mean, see what a single enemy can do to you, especially if they have a two-handed weapon. I guess we can apply the leeches because this will not heal on its own, not in a million years. Also, the pain is growing and I have nothing for the pain anymore. I guess we can throw it in the head of someone. But that's... This is what I don't like about the game in the beginning. As you can see, trying to heal in the beginning, it's so weird. You can heal, but you get pain. Once you finish with the pain, you can get intoxication. So it's a kind of like a never-ending cycle. And I should be healed more than this. Pain should be about 10% or 15%. We also didn't find any traps and nothing good. Okay, I don't want to fight the boss and the henchman at the same time, so let's go. This is the guy that cornered me, can you believe it? Nice. I believe this should make only the small guy come out. No one comes out to kill me? That's curious. Wait, is this stolen? Why is this stolen? I don't admit anything. Okay, we leveled up, but we also got smashed in the head. I don't think I have a chance of beating the boss. So let's be sad over here by the gate. Yeah, this is usually how it goes for me. I just sit outside very, very sad. I think I'll just get dexterity because it gives me, well, dexterity, agility. It gives me more stuff like dodge, move. Counter chance, minus fumble chance, yeah, it's so much better, but 1 point, it's kind of like a big nerf in my opinion. Oh, we're almost out of food, wow, we had so much food and then suddenly something happened and we're out of food. Well, I think we can go back in and teach him who's boss. I am the boss. Yeah, I should have waited more, but I'm too lazy. I got stunned again. What are the chances? I mean, days, but still. This is the first time I see the boss running away from me. That was very funny. The boss was running away from me. You don't see that every day. So let me see now. And main swords. Three. Well, I guess I only need 3 of them. These are worthless. I don't know why I take them in my inventory. I guess I can try to identify that. I just like the sound of it. Also, the coin purse is super important. I guess you have to rest a little bit because that was a very taxing fight. So as you can see, it's just about a little bit of luck, a little bit of management, a little bit of more management, even more and more management. Now sadly I was already in the kitchen and the kitchen is empty. So if someone wants to fight me from here, we'll be in trouble. I guess we can cleanse this and see. Yeah, okay, it's probably better to use that right now. So this is a two-handed weapon. I guess I would use it, but yeah, it's just too much to handle. At least for now. Oh, hello little there, my little friend. A ring. Experience gain 2%. That's not so bad. Backfire chance. So I guess that's for the mage. Well, I guess we can equip it over there. That will not bring us any money. No, I guess it's just better to put the X over here, because again, that will not bring us more money anyway. How is my food situation? 22. We are hitting the head, so we have no clear idea of where we are going. Okay, that's nice. Also I didn't see any traps in here, so being confused is not such a big debuff for us because we'll never move in a trap. Ah, bottle of oil, good vendor stuff. I don't think there is any enemy left, because if there was an enemy, he would have heard us. Remember, this is one of the more recent changes where the enemies can hear you, so... Yeah, that was also modified. Okay, that was not so bad. Could have been worse, I mean, we could have died a lot of times. And that's kind of like the first dungeon experience. Sometimes it's much worse than this, but I guess I did it so many times, I'm almost immune to it. Oh, a dog pelt, no. Let's put the rest of the leaves over there, okay. I guess that's very cheap. Okay, let's put that over there. I guess we'll find some other items to take with us in our journey. Okay, so what is the quest? What plants do I have to bring the herbalist? Agrimony, Fleawarf and Spearmint. Well, I don't think I'll find any of them over here. Rhubarb, I think it was good for eating, right? But it intoxicates me, but it increases my immunity, let's see. Well, it's more or less worth it. Oh yes, this brings back so many memories. So I'll not do every dungeon on camera. I'll just do the first two dungeons. Maybe I'll also do a little bit of inventory management. The next time we see each other will be at the doors of the next dungeon. I'll also buy a lot of new gear, of course. Agrimony, Fleawort and Spearmint. Spearmint. I guess I can gather them from next to the village.
Yeah.
And that's our first adventure concluded happily ever after. I mean, I did die two times, but that was off camera, so it doesn't count. And those deaths are almost accidental. Oh, horsetail. I guess I'm getting closer to the herbs I need. So the game is much better now than it was in the beginning. It's much more balanced and you have a lot more activities, but the beginning is slower than ever. No, never has the game been so slow to start. Yeah, you have sticks, you have mushrooms, you have that, but does it really help you? Not really. As a little reminder, you can make a fireplace now. And if you have a bedroll, you can also save. But I think you can only save once with a bedroll, I'm not sure. And you can also be ambushed while sleeping, which sounds like a terrible idea most of the times. Especially if you don't have armor. When you don't have armor, you are a walking purse coin. Okay, I'm happy we got to complete some quests. Wait, what was the quest for the tailor? Oh, bear pelt. Oh, that will take me a little while longer. Bison pelt and horns. Okay, we have safely made it back home. Yeah, I guess that boss was not so tough, but it can be hard to defeat him with his little helpers helping him. I guess by the time we go back to sleep, we'll be full health and no injuries. Well, I think it's better to sell the oil to him, this to him. 49 to him. Don't sell that. It's just so tempting. So 35 and 250 to... Oh, that's actually super expensive. Whatever, that's not expensive, so I'll just sell it to him. That amulet is looking very nice, to be honest. Yeah, so you can only use it once, so I guess you have to take the bedroll with you and use it after you clear a part of the dungeon, or I don't know. Okay, let's finish his task. 250 gold. Nope, not interested in anything. Can you teach me something? Oh, I forgot he gives you the beginning lesson in maces. Well, that's good. I should have known that earlier, but it's okay. We will handle it. Onslaught. Dazed or armor break. No, I think this was the best one because it knocks them back and it also burns a lot of energy and also let's just take it. We'll speak about it later. So basically if you do this quest you can get the maces for free, the training for free. Okay, I forgot again, what was the price he was giving me for this? 35, 250, dude. That's actually a very good thing to find. So as you can see, the pelts are in a much better position right now. I think any pelt is better than the rusty weapons you can get in the beginning. I think I should have saved the other pelt, but no, I couldn't do that. 35, 40, so it's a little more expensive over here. Oh yeah, that's pretty good actually. Sometimes I like to buy this one just because it gives me so much more physical resistance than what you have before. As for the armor, to be honest, there's nothing better than your armor in the beginning, unless you find the... Well, you will not find it. Also buy a better cloak. Not really worth it. I guess in the beginning you'll have a surplus of money just because you don't have enough items to buy, and I think that's a bad thing. Imagine this, you have so much money to buy stuff, but you have nothing to buy. I guess you can buy a lot of medical supplies, but still it's the same problem, it persists. Oh wow, that's actually pretty interesting. So that's 9% physical resistance minus 1 fumble chance. Okay, that's a very lucky roll. So yeah, what am I supposed to do with the money in the beginning? I don't know. I guess we put it in the bank, invested for later in shares. Invested later in shares. Carpenter? Oh, we also got the Carpenter quest, Fate of the Brewery. Okay, I guess we can go to the brewery and... Well, I guess I'll have to do the mission. I'll do the mission and then one... The next episode will do the brewery as well. Well, that was very entertaining. Actually, let me go again to the blacksmith, because I want to show you why the game is a little worse right now. If you're not lucky enough to find the gear you need, you could be waiting for hours to get what you need thanks to this new system where you have to level up your reputation a lot and you also cannot sleep to refresh their inventories. See? Not much I can buy from him. This is very interesting to me. Okay, I guess I'll do a lot of stuff off camera and we'll see each other in the next episode where we'll have a lot more luck, maybe. Who knows? Bye.